Hi everyone, welcome back to bankexamsToday.com, and this is our 5 minutes vocabulary day 8 video, which I'm making after a very long time because due to bad weather I felt sick and I couldn't make videos due to my bad throat. But right now we have just 3 videos left, day 28, 29 and 30th. After that you will get the PDF with 300 words of vocabulary made easy. So let's start with the day 21. The very first word we have is fraught. Fraught means the tension or the worry, something that gives you stress, like this person is having so many papers to check and that is causing stress to him. So fraught means that something that causes you stress, and it is an adjective. Okay, so after CM said the state is in a political fraught situation. Situation, as you know, is a noun. And the verb used before situation is fraught, which makes it an adjective. Okay, synonyms will be anxious, worried, upset and frantic. Antonyms will be still. It means you do not have any tensions, no worries, tranquil, quiet, peace, serene or undisturbed. The second word is palpable. Palpable means something that is very much noticeable. For example, there are things of black color everywhere, but there is just one thing which is of red or bright yellow color, so that will be easily noticed or easily felt or touched. Okay, so noticeable, very clear to recognize, is called palpable. Like there are people in gray colors and there is just one person in orange. Okay, so he is easy to recognize, noticeable. Because the bank was being robbed, the sense of fear among the patrons was palpable. It means the people were feared, people were afraid, and therefore that fear was very much apparent on their faces. Antonyms will be intangible, imperceptible. It means hard to recognize, hard to solve. Ambiguous, which means not very clear. Improbable and unknown. Third word is lackluster. Luster means shine. And when we are using the word lack means scarcity of something. So lackluster means lacking shine or glitter, something which is very dull and boring, uninspiring. Like this scene is lacking luster. For example, no excuses were made for the team's lackluster performance. It means that the team did not perform really well and there was no excuse for it, and the team's performance, lackluster performance, seems dull performance or lifeless performance. Okay, so antonyms will be bright, because opposite of shine, lack of shining will be having some shine, so it will be bright. Enthusiastic, lively or shining. Then comes the word professed. Professed means that is claimed openly. If I say I am the best teacher, okay, there are teachers who are better than me, but I am claiming it openly, but it may be false. Like there are claims that this barber, this person can hypnotize people. It is claimed openly, but can he actually hypnotize people? It can be a false statement. Okay, so professed means that is claimed openly, but that have the chances of being false. Adam may profess he is a man of God. Means he can claim openly that he worships God, but his extramarital affairs proves otherwise. It means if he is having so much faith in God, so he won't cheat on his wife. That is not a godly manner of treating somebody's wife. So you can profess that I do this, I can do that, then that, but it can be false. So the synonyms will be so-called, pretended, ostensible. Antonyms, understate, means not stated properly. Disregard, ignore, it means you're not emphasizing on something. Neglect or disown, you disapprove that this is not correct, is disowned. And the last word for today is encapsulate. Encapsulate, capsule, if you have seen capsules, they are very tiny and small, but they consist of the medicine that is very powerful. So when you encapsulate something, this is a verb. You are trying to explain something in a very brief manner. Suppose there is a chapter of 25 pages, okay, but your teacher provides you something in just 10 or 5 pages. So she encapsulated the entire gist of the chapter. Like we provide you the summary of Yojana magazine. Actually, the magazine is having like 20 to 30 pages, but we cover it in just 5 pages. So we are just encapsulating it. We are containing so much of content in just 5 or 6 pages. The conclusion is encapsulated in one sentence. It means the whole conclusion of the passage or the essay is just encapsulated in one sentence. Synonyms: confine, contain. Contain means to fill in. Condense or abbreviate. Antonyms: elongated. It means you are trying to lengthen it. You are trying to make it lengthy. Extend. Trying to extend it, lengthen it, prolong it. Amplify or elaborate it. So this is all for today's day 28 video. And if you have any doubts, you can email your doubts at insia@bankexamstoday, and you can download the PDF from the description box, or you can wait till day 30th so that you can download all the PDFs at once. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, keep practicing and work hard.